Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about all the new flow enhancement or new flow features that are coming up along with Summer 23 release. So without any further delay, let's jump into a Summer 23 release org and see these new features in action. So the first feature that I'll be talking today is about how to include the search bar in the data table. So let's see that in action. So here I am in my Summer 23 release org. I'll start by creating a new flow and I will choose a screen flow. The first thing that I'll do, I'll fetch all the contacts from this org. So get records and get all contacts. And all records, no condition and done. Now I'll start by putting a screen element. Here I'll search for data table. And in the data table, here I'll put the name as all contacts. The collection is basically the contacts, which I've fetched already. And here, this is a new thing. The moment I click on this one, you'll find this option here. So it's basically telling is that from this data table, you can have the option of putting a search bar and you can do the search. You can configure the rows. Like here you can select whether you want to allow selecting multiple rows or the single row, or you want to make this data table a completely view only data table. In the configure columns, you can put all the columns that you want to put here. For example, I want to put, for example, the contact first name or contact full name. And let's put one more column, which is contact's email address. And done and click on save. Summer 23 and save. And let's go and do the debug. When I do the debug, what I can see is that it's showing all the contacts and here is a search bar. Here, if I put John and enter, it's showing me the John Bond. This is a contact. Basically, what it's doing is that it will show all the contacts, but when the list is huge, it makes sense to have a search functionality. And that's what this new feature is all about. It will give you the search functionality on the data table. With that, let's move to the next feature. So the next feature which I'm going to talk about is basically a searchable choice set in the choice lookup component. So let's see that in an example. So here I am in the same Summer 23 release org. I'll start by creating a screen element. Let's give it a name. Here I'll choose the choice lookup. Show all contacts. And here I'm going to choose a new choice resource and let's choose the record choice set and here I'll select from the contact object and no conditions. The label is name and it goes to the name field. That's all I need to do and click on save. Done and let's save as and now let's go and do the debug. When I do the debug, I can see it's basically a choice lookup field and it shows all the contacts, but the beauty is that with Summer 23 release, you basically have the option to type and it will do the search for you. Perfect. And it's a very powerful feature. So with that, we'll move to the next new feature from Summer 23 release. The next feature is how you can call the HTTP POST method from your Salesforce flow. This is a very powerful feature and this is one of my favorite features from Summer 23 release. This feature is currently in a beta stage, but I have a dedicated video covering this feature, how you can configure HTTP POST method call from your Salesforce flow. I'll put the link on the top right corner as well as in the description of this video, so you should definitely go and check that out. But here is a flow which I have already built And again, you should always go and check my other video where I've shown you step-by-step a way to configure your flow so that you can call a HTTP POST method. This is the end result. And if I go and do the debug, what you can see that this flow is doing a POST call. Here is the input to my POST call and here is the output. So it proves that now after summer 23 release from your Salesforce flow, you can call HTTP POST method. With that, I'll go to the next feature. So the next feature is how you can create a reactive screen components. So let's see that example in a summer 23 release org. So the first thing that you need to do, you need to go to the settings and then process automation settings. And at the very end of the page, you will find an option called opt into the reactive screen beta. You need to enable that. Once it's enabled, I've already configured this flow. What this flow is basically doing, I have a slider and basically when I'll change the value, it will show the corresponding number of months. For example, if I make it 1, it will show 12. If I make it 2, it will show 24, like 2 years equals to 24 months. The way I've configured is basically a slider. It will increment in a step of 1. The minimum value is 0, maximum value is 30. And this one is basically a formula field, which is month's formula. And here is the value. So whatever value that I'm getting from the slider, I'm multiplying by 12. Now let's debug the flow. I'll skip the first screen and go to the next one. As you can see here, I have a slider and I have a box here, which is basically showing the number of months. The moment I change the value in the slider, the corresponding months is getting displayed here. So this value is basically changing based on the value, based on my interaction on the slider. So this is a feature which is getting introduced in summer 23 release and currently it's in a beta 1. So with that, let's move to the next one. So the next one that I'll be talking today is called the powerful send email action. So let's see this in an example. So what I'll do here, I will add this action and it's called the send email action. What you can see here, there are a couple of changes that is coming up. One is this email template ID. Once you select that, you can basically add your Lightning email template. One important feature is log email on send. The moment you enable that, it's basically telling that any email interaction, you can log this as an activity against that record. And this is a very important feature that is getting introduced along with summer 23 release. So with that, let's move to the next feature. So the next feature is telling about how we can get rid of process builder, because after summer 23 release, you are not supposed to create any more process builder in your org and you should move slowly all your existing process builder into flow. Also, the another feature that I'll be talking and I'll be showing you in the next demo is that in your process builder, when you have a scheduled action and you want to replace that process builder with the flow after summer 23 release, all your scheduled actions from the process builder is supported now in the flow migration process. So let's see that in an example. So what I've done, I have created a process builder and basically what this process builder is doing is it is having a scheduled action. And my intention is to get rid of this process builder and migrate this process builder into flow. So what I will do, I'll go with migrate to flow. And here it's already showing there is a process builder. I'll select that and I'll click on migrate to flow. And it's telling that, okay, select this one and migrate to flow. And let's open this flow in the flow builder. And as you can see, my process builder was having a schedule path. And when I've migrated this to flow, it already took care of that schedule action. So after summer 23 release, if you are migrating any process builder which is having any schedule action, you can handle those schedule action and still migrate those process builder into flow. This is a very powerful enhancement that was introduced along with summer 23 release. That's all I'd like to cover in this video. I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share, and also please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.